guys, how's it going? Today I'm proud to present to you 2017 brand spanking new Kia Optima. In this video I'm going to show you the interior solid state steering wheel score. And here's the key, lock on lock control button. Let's start the engine, let it run for a while. Also, this car comes equipped with a smart key access system. Right now the car is locked. To unlock, press this button once, and of course the mirrors fold out and fold in like so, and to lock, press once again. It's quite easy, and the mirrors fold in. Chrome door handles. This car has 6 airbags. Doors, very wide opening, it's almost like 90 degree, providing easy entry and exit. Black leather interior, perforated seats, heated and cooled, red stitching. Awesome. 3-spoke design, fully wrapped steering wheel. Good sound isolation. And this seat moves forward. Six-speed automatic transmission and also six-speed manual transmission is available. Sport grips up top, red stitching, perforated inserts, 3-9, flat button design, very nice, GT line. Actually, this version is fully loaded, 2.4 liter, inline 4, 16 valve, gasoline direct injection, GDI. It produced 188 horsepower, not bad. In order to start the engine, put your foot on the brake and then hit button start, right here. Very nice startup. This car comes equipped with electrically assisted power steering companion, perforated steering wheel, not bad, horn. Tilt and telescopic to adjust. Use this lever right there. It's quite easy to adjust. Nice. This car has automatic lights and automatic rain sensing windshield wipers. Right now, that's an headlight, rear fog light, high beam, full set lights. On a base version, 2-liter MPI engine is available. 150 horsepower, and top trim GT has 2-liter turbocharged GDI engine. It produces 245 horsepower. Awesome. 2-person memory for the driver's seat. Basically, very elegant door handles. Your bar mirrors, left and right, up and down. They also heated. Blind spot monitoring system right there. And of course, power folding, automatic mode. Very convenient feature, especially in tight parking spaces. Nice. panel them right here. Turn off the blind spot monitoring system. Blind spot detection. On and off. Of course, your trunk release, fuel cap release. Turn off the traction control. Sweet. Power window lock. Of course, your central lock. And all four windows in this car are fully automatic in both direction, up and down. Rear windows. Sunshield. Alright guys, right now, let's open the hood and take a good look at the exterior of this car. Lower right there to open the hood. Panoramic moonroof, rain guards, sharp thin antenna, rear defrosting glass, chrome, as you can see, very nice looking, LED inserts, tail lights, dual polished exhaust pipes, rear diffuser. LED third brake light and rear defrosting glass. GT line, as you can see. Main variables for this car is a Toyota Camry, Mazda 6, VW Passat, Skoda Superb, and I believe Ford Mondeo. Available 17-inch and on the top trim 18-inch rims available. Tires measuring 235-45 Michelin tires, beautiful factory rims, front ventless disc brakes and rear solid disc brakes.
LED turn signal case next to your mirrors, very bright. Side view camera right here. Chrome on the front fenders. Your VIN number right there. Headlamps is available. This car has Visinon adaptive headlamps, and on the top trim, full LED adaptive headlamps is available. Project Visinon adaptive headlamps, LED daytime running lights, headlight washers, and also LED fog lights is available. Front parking assist, Tiger nose grille, chrome, high gloss black finish, front view camera. So guys, first test drive of this car. Right, gonna change language right now. English, yep. Always buckle up, don't drink and drive, drive safe. This car has inline 4, 16 valve.
GDI engine, gasoline direct injection, and produce 188 horsepower, a lot of torque. The base version has Toyota MPI, 150 horsepower, and manual transmission. This one has 188 and a top trim. Actually, this is GT line, and the top trim has Toyota turbocharged GDI engine. It produces 245 horsepower, of course, front wheel drive only. Independent McPherson Strut suspension with anti-roll bar up front and multi-link suspension with anti-roll bar out back. Quite a peppy engine, eco mode, and right now fuel economy is around 12.5 liter per 100 kilometer. I think this is a good result. Very interesting steering. Of course, we have sport mode here, auto dimming rearview mirror, panoramic moonroof, just amazing. This car rocks, definitely. No doubt about that. And silky smooth 6-speed automatic transmission, quiet engine, interesting steering. This car moves. No way, this Lada Granta. Alright, how it sounds once again. To repeat this track and to shuffle basically. All right. Wow, that was fast. This car pulls. By the way, seats for me is quite comfortable. Four-way ball on board is available, but this car doesn't have Lexus Thunder, but Kia Cadenza has it. There is no soft closing doors, no power trunk. Like I mentioned before, main rivals for this car is Toyota Camry, Mazda 6, Honda Accord, Ford Mondeo, and I believe VW Passat. Acceleration is just amazing. Eco mode, right now, eco mode is on. Actually, guys, this car has quite a sensitive brakes. No doubt about that. Very soft suspension, no problem at all. As you can see, sharp steering, love it. This car is not gonna be so fast, but right now I'm truly surprised. This car is fast. And don't forget, we have a GT version, 245 horsepower. That's a quick car. Good sound isolation for this class. Good warranty, of course. Resale value is just excellent. Way to go, Kia. Well, guys, hope you enjoy this test drive, this 2017 brand spec new Kia Optima GT line. Thanks for watching once again.
Red painted calipers, awesome. Alright guys, right now we take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion. The most interesting part. Seat under panels. Harman Kardon premium audio with 10 speakers, subwoofer and amplifier. Storage area, bottle holder, soft leather wrap armrest, high gloss black finish. Very nice attention to the details. Aluminum entry guards, Kia. Your tire pressure right there. Driver's seat has power adjustment, standard sliding right there, recline, four-way power lumbar, seats are quite comfortable, adjustable headrests and seat belts, aluminum support pedals, illumination, fuse box located right here. Alright guys, right now, let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Well, definitely, this car is happy to rev. Not bad. Easy to read gauges, by the way. And here's your light indicator controls, your intermittent wiper controls right there.
your paddle shifters right here, minus 40 downshift and plus 40 upshift. Also, I believe in UK estate version of Kia Optima is available. Infotainment screen, 7-inch screen is available and 8-inch screen is available. How it sounds. SD card for the navigation right now. It's not available. Alright. You can raise and lower the volume, mute, select between different track or select between different station, on hook and off buttons for a telephone, and also via Bluetooth. You can connect telephone and receive calls, Bluetooth stream of audio, cruise control settings, speed limiter, and driver information system right there. Quite easy to use. Sorry guys. Let's see your digital speedometer. Little display. Average and current fuel economy. Trip A, trip B. Set temperature. Lapse time. Stamped average and current fuel economy. So, your compass. Your audio information. Service and general settings. Driving assist, rear cross traffic alert, then door, smart trunk, lights, sound adjustment, and it's pretty much self-explanatory. Then convenience, service interval, motor features. That's pretty much it for the system. Quite easy to use. Overall build quality and all the materials and the score are very nice. First price, good warranty, good resale value. That's aftermarket rear detector. Alright, once again, infotainment screen. Adjustment for the navigation right now, it's not available. Sound adjustment, display settings, Bluetooth system and Wi-Fi hotspot. For the display, sound adjustment, tone control, reset, bass, treble, mid-range, as you can see, quite easy to adjust, then advanced, SDVC is available, on and off, volume, beeping, display settings, basically, you can adjust brightness, daytime mode and nighttime mode, Bluetooth settings, cancel. Alright. System settings. You can choose your desirable language right here. Keyboard, then clock, unit, and back to factory settings. So guys, that's pretty much it for the system. Alright. And your compass. Map is not available right now. Armor cotton, seatbelt warning, and passenger back indicator. Alright, let's see what I got here. Media, USB, USB image, iPod, Bluetooth audio, and auxiliary. List, song, album, options. That's your menu, main menu for the radio, list, presets, and then options. So in general, not bad. As you can see, clean air, built-in air filter, interesting vans, head climate, dual zone fully automatic climate control, temperature adjustment, one touch automatic, off, fan speed control, very nice, front rear defrost, air conditioning on and off, recycle settings, for the passenger, sink. Quite nice. Just set it and forget it.
Alright guys, right here you can find your USB auxiliary integration power supply and wireless phone charger. And you need the adapter for the iPhone.
6-speed silky smooth automatic transmission, reverse rear view camera, good guidance lines. Awesome. Side view, front view camera, not bad. And bird eye view.
Very quick at the same time. I'm not disappointed at all.
Your drive mode, of course, plus for the upshift and minus for the downshift. Silky smooth transmission. Your seat cup holders right here, hidden. If you want to hide something right there. Camera activation and deactivation drive mode. Basically, it's eco. Helps you to save fuel just a little bit. And sport mode.
Heated steering wheel. Awesome feature. Heated seats. Three stage. For the driver and for the passenger. High, medium, low and off. And cooled seats, of course. Three stage also. Not bad. Then your parking assist, turn off the parking sensors, electronic parking brake with auto hold function, to engage it just pull and to disengage put your foot on the brake and then just pressing it. That easy. That's your park pilot right there, hit this button, parking surge as you can see. Not bad. Alright, your armrest, soft, storage tray, get some storage down there. Auto dim rear view mirror, as you can see. Sunglass container is also padded, not bad. Interior illumination, it's all LED, microphone for the hands-free. And this shade, panoramic moonroof, looks amazing. And I believe this is Alcantara, but I'm not quite sure about that. All right. Vent mirror with illumination, card holder, warning. Your panels up top, very good visibility of my 6'3" stature. Those seats are extremely nice for me. Legroom is more than enough. Thigh support is pretty good, and shoulder room is okay. You can definitely feel this true South Korean quality. No doubt about that. Just a wonderful car for its price. And warranty, 5 years in Europe, I believe. It's around 7 years, even for the powertrain. It's just incredible. Interesting steering, sensitive brakes. Wow, way to go, Kia. Alright, let's shut her down. Let's grab the key and that chime. Let's grab the key and continue restore. The city's moving. Cap release right here. And here's your fuel cap. Hold it right there. I'll let it fuel only. Second row is also quite roomy. Child safety locks right here. And materials to carry over. Storage compartment, soft leather armrest. High-class black finish, 2-stage heated seats, aluminum entry guards, key, back seats is default, 60-40 split, Pacific system, adjustable headrests, of course.
6 foot three stature.
It's quite easy to get in and out. A lot of space for me. Storage pockets and right there. Perfect inserts, very nice. Rear vents, power supply, and USB to charge phone basically, or your MP3 player. Santa tunnel, outside bag, sunshade right here. All right, LED illumination, internal illumination, cut hack. Soft leather wrap armrest with two cup holders. Back visibility is pretty good, but my headroom is limited due to this panoramic moonroof. Not bad. Also for this side, heated seats. Exquisite Optima interior, GT line. Alright guys, right now, let's check trunk space, shall we? Trunk's huge. Emergency release right here. Not bad. Illumination. And down here to find your full-size spare tire, tools, and jack. Fold down receipts basically. One convenient handle to close trunk lid. Same smart key access system. Two-way roll lumbar and same adjustment.
Central lock and power window. Of course, glove box is lockable. Very deep with illumination.
So, in general, this South Korean car, very nicely equipped for its price, quite reliable, but good warranty and same time good resale value. Way to go Kia and Honda, of course. Well guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2017 brand spanking new Kia Optima. Thanks for watching and